So today I didn't have anything else to do, so I decided to read Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them by J.K. Rowling, and I really loved the book. So while reading and learning about all those fantastic beasts and beautiful creatures, not the book, beautiful creatures, all the creatures in this book, I just wondered if anyone did a tag like this. So I really loved the idea and I thought, why wouldn't I do something like that? That's when I decided to make this tag and I hope that you will like it. My name is Catherine and today we are doing Fantastic Beast Tag. So this is how this tag works. I chose seven Fantastic Beasts. They're not all from these books, some of them are from some other fantasy books or something like that. And for each of those beasts, I have a task for you, so you have to find a book for every of these beasts. So the first one on my list is Unicorn. Unicorn is a being of pure magic. Choose a book or book series with your favorite magical system. For this one, I had to choose Mistborn by Brandon Sanderson because I really loved the idea in this book and the whole magical system. Because if you don't know what these books are about, and if you don't know what this whole magical system is about, people in these books have the ability to burn metal, and by doing it, they can produce magic. And this magical system is so complex, and the idea is so great that I just had to choose these books. And Brandon Sanderson knows how to create those wonderful worlds and those wonderful magical abilities. So in his other book called Warbreaker, people can do magic, and it is connected with colors. So I'm not really sure how it works because I haven't read this book yet, but I'm really looking forward to reading it, and I'm sure that it would be as great as his Mistborn trilogy because his work is just fantastic. My next beast is Dragon. That is a book that unexpectedly sets you on fire. So that is a book which had an unexpected twist at the end or somewhere in the book. And for this one, I had to choose Age of the Five trilogy by Trudy Canavan. And this trilogy has many different twists and turns, and that is why I really loved it. And there are some things that I couldn't really predict in this trilogy and in this story. So I'm talking about a certain character, and I didn't really expect what happened to him and what he really turned out to be. So that is that twist, and I'm not going to tell you anything else, but you should definitely check this trilogy out because that is fantasy trilogy, which has an interesting view on the religion and on all the gods and things like that. So I really enjoyed it, and this is my unexpected twist and turn. So, dragon. Then the next creature is Vampire. That is a book world that sucked you in. This is where you have to find a book world that you found the most interesting. So for this one, I chose The Last Stormlord by Glenda Lark and the whole trilogy because I have never read anything like this before. Because this is the fantasy trilogy about a world where there is no water. World creation in this book is really wonderful, and I've never read anything like that before, as I've already said. So if you're looking for something really different from all the other fantasy books out there, you should definitely pick this book up because world building in this book is phenomenal and you won't regret it, I promise. I would never want to live in a world like this, but it is interesting to read about it. The next creature is Elf. You should choose some series of books. series that has more than 3 books. And for this one, I had to pick Vampire Academy because this is my favorite series, and there are 6 books, and then there are Bloodlines books, which are something like a sequel to the Vampire Academy, so there are a lot of books there. So for the long living creature, I chose Vampire Academy. Then the next creature is Siren, and for this one, you have to choose something beautiful and appealing. You have to choose a book with a beautiful cover. I bought this book recently and I haven't held it yet, so this is a little sneak peek, but I'm sure that you've seen this book. And that book is The Kiss of Deception, and I really, really love the cover, and the spine is also beautiful, and it really looks interesting, and I'm not sure if you can see this sign here, but this book really is beautiful, and this color is just amazing, and I really, really love this cover. So this is what I chose for the beautiful cover, and we have a map there, and it is on the inside of the cover. The next book is Sphinx. So Sphinx is a creature that likes telling riddles, and because of that, you have to choose a book that you found confusing, that you couldn't really understand. And for this one, I chose Gardens of the Moon by Steven Erikson. I tried reading this book 2 years ago, and I read the first half of it, and then I stopped because I couldn't really understand a thing in this book. And I know that many people loved this series and that they really enjoyed it, and I heard that everything is explained later on and that you should really have a lot of patience. You should wait until you finish the second book because that's when everything starts to unfold and things like that. But I didn't really have patience, and as you can see, this book is huge. So I'm not sure if I'm ever going to continue on with the series, but I would really love to see why everyone is telling me that and what the whole thing is about and things like that. But for now, this is my confusing creature. And at last, Werewolf. So you have to choose a book, or a book cover to be precise, cover change that you liked or disliked the most. And for this one, I had to pick Obsidian and the whole Lux series because this is the cover that I have, and there's been a cover change. So now we have the bind up of the first 2 books, and then bind up of the second 2 books, and then the 5th book, which is completely different to all of these books that I have, and now I'll have to buy the 5th book, and the books won't match on my shelf, and I don't really want to buy those bind-ups, so I'm really angry about that. So that would be all the creatures that I chose, and that would be all the questions that I wanted you to answer. So I'm going to tag a few people, or not a few, a lot of people, and I'm going to leave their names in the description below. So, or if I haven't tagged you, feel free to do this tag, and I really hope that you enjoyed it. I know that I did, and if you did enjoy this tag, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you in some of my next videos, which will hopefully be very soon.